Alright, I've got it fixed. Alright, Merry Christmas Eve, guys. How's it going? Welcome to Awaken for just this Christmas Eve part. And we're in part two of the Immanuel. I just want to take a little bit of time, not a whole lot of time out of your Christmas Eve. Just kind of reflect on kind of what God has just poured into me through this Immanuel series. I know yesterday we kind of did the part one of this series, which was just talking about how to hear from God. Because we hear so many lies spoken into our life from us, from the enemy, and from the world. So the thing about it, we just wanted to be able to hear clearly for what God has for us, and especially into this season as we just celebrate Immanuel, God with us, and how grateful we are because he decided to walk with us, become part of us, and just be amongst us. And we can do, well, we'll get into a little bit of that, but regardless, we're here to celebrate him on this Christmas Eve, and we always want to kind of set some time aside just to always take every opportunity to celebrate Jesus and everything that he's done and what he continually does. And with that, I just want to open up in prayer as we just get ready. Thank you, Father, for this Christmas Eve and just this day that we're sitting beside of you and everything that you have done and the provisions that you have made for us, how you've made a way for us, how you wasn't content just being a God above us, that you wanted to be God among us, walk with us, have a relationship with us, and just be part of our lives. And we thank you for that, especially in this holiday season, as we just set aside time to be thankful and set aside time to be giving, because you gave so abundantly to us. We just always want to give back to you and give back to our loved ones and just represent you. Jesus, we just thank you and be with my words today as we just celebrate Christmas Eve with you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. All right, guys. Bye. Yesterday we kind of opened up in Matthew, and I'm just going to reread Matthew 1, verses 18 through 25, because that's just our heartbeat through this Immanuel series, and hopefully some new insights going to be found. Just as this Christmas Eve is the eve of something great that God did back those 2,000 years ago, and that's what we're going to celebrate. We're on the eve of something amazing. We're on the eve, we're on the verge of just a breakthrough, amazing things going to come, and amazing things going to happen in your life as you're just here on this eve, as we celebrate this eve. And Matthew 1 starts off, "Now the birth of Jesus took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit." I just kind of want to stop there and kind of paint a picture of what Immanuel really means. We're talking about Christmas Eve. Now, even though I know that this Jesus really wasn't born in December, but this is the day we're celebrating. So whatever day before he actually came to earth as the form of a baby, it was on the eve, that Christmas. And we just wanted to take a moment just to paint this picture. Just think about this. He was up high in the Trinity, just in unison with God, and he gave up so much. And just think about it as he was preparing that day before he knew he was going to step into this world, take the form of a baby, a small infant that couldn't even take care of itself. He was that humbling to himself, to us, that he gave his big position up to humble himself to be in the form of a little infant baby who could not even take care of himself, who had to lean on Mary and Joseph to take care of him, to nourish him. He was putting himself in the hands of humans, in the position of us. He was breaking the whole barrier down because he wasn't content being separated from us any longer. And just I'm just imagining him being up in heaven, just preparing himself as he's getting ready to step foot into mankind. As he was up there with his father, just kind of getting ready for this, the breaking down this barrier in the form of a baby. And for me, it's just painting that picture of a God Almighty up high, just being glorified, being celebrated by angels. And he's up there and talking about being surrounded by lightning and thunders and everything else in this position up high. He had every need. He had no want. He was God living up high and giving it all up, giving up everything to be born as a baby. Like I said, I've got a little nephew who's now about a year old, but regardless, I didn't think about my kids as being as a baby, of being just so small and having to be coddled and hold, and your every meal has to be provided by you. Your diapers have to even be changed for you. I'm sure they didn't have diapers back then, but God having to be changed is just humbling in itself. God gave up a position up high to be humble, to be a servant, to come to love us and to humble himself and become a man, in every essence becoming a man, to the very form of being a baby. Especially, you know, like kind of thing about Ricky Bobby, the 10-pound Jesus or whatever. I can't remember exactly what he said, but regardless, that's how we think about Jesus a lot of times. But he did. He humbled himself to be a baby, to walk with us and be born of Mary. And he gave up all comfort to take that place. And so we're kind of moving on. And it goes on to say, before they came together, and her husband Joseph, being a just man and willing to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. Joseph knew this was not his child. Joseph knew something was up, but God was at work. And what should be a shameful moment, regardless, people did not know that it was God in her. And this would have been a very shameful moment. And Joseph could have blasted it out. He could have said, well, my wife's done cheated on me. She's got a child by somebody else. And he could have made a big deal about it. But I think God was painting a very beautiful picture that we don't always have to let what other people think about. Don't have to dictate our situation, that he defines us. He speaks truth into us. And we see that as Joseph could have just blasted it out, but he decided to be a graceful man and do it quietly. But God had bigger plans. He said, don't let this deter you. He went on to say, but as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. It's something greater than you know. It's something bigger than you can ever expect. There's something powerful in this. Don't let this shame, don't let this disgrace hold you down, because regardless, Joseph was still going to feel shame because he was still with Mary, with a child that was not his. And he knew this, but he was still taking it on. He knew God had greater things. So many times in our lives, we have to not let other people dictate our situation. We have to really realize that God has greater things for us. And we can't always look at what people are going to think about us or how people are going to judge us. Well, regardless, we have to walk it out. And Joseph, hearing this, it says, all this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. And this was the first appearance of the name Immanuel. And it goes on, behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Immanuel, which means God with us. So Joseph was getting ready for something amazing. Joseph was getting ready for something powerful, even though he did not completely understand. And it says, when Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife. He didn't let the situation deter him. He didn't let what other people would think hold him back. He stepped up. He stepped up as a man to take care of this baby that's infant. God in infant form. And I just want to be clearly to paint this picture. An infant, a baby. But it goes on, but knew her not until, and pretty much he did not have relations with her until after she'd given birth to a son. So he was letting Mary have this holy place, the sanction of being still pure as she was conceiving a child, as she was getting ready to give birth to God among us. And Joseph didn't try to have relations with her. He just let her be this vessel to be used. And when the child was born, he called his name Jesus. They were celebrating it. And God stepped forth into this and being born as a baby, and not even in high places. You can read like into the Luke's representation of this Christmas scene, and we can see that he was even humble enough that he wasn't born in a nice place. He gave himself so lowly to be born in a manger. I was listening to a pastor speak yesterday, talking about the manger being something. It was a feeding trough. It was something that you would feed your animals in. And God took place, be born in this manger, in this lowly of lowly, to just giving up everything, giving up all his dignity, just to be born of this baby in a manger. Look at is how much he was willing to give up so we could be at peace with him. And like I said, God was at the eve of something. He was ready to give himself up fully, to give himself completely for us. And now we're standing here on the eve of something, and it's the eve of Christmas, being able to celebrate. But I just don't want anybody to ever just celebrate just kind of Christmas as just this one-time event. It's a reoccurring thing. It should be a daily thing for us. It's God in us. Like I spoke last week about the Jesus to life, and Mary is alive in us. It's rejuvenating us. It's putting us on a new path. It's giving us on a purpose. And I'm here to encourage anybody listening. I'm here to even encourage myself. We are on the eve of a breakthrough. You're on the eve of something new. Just get ready for this Christmas season to celebrate something new, something exciting, the eve on something. And as you wake up tomorrow on Christmas, be renewed in your mind, knowing that God has greater things, that He's got you on a purpose. And as we finish up this year, as we celebrate Christmas, let Christmas mean something completely new to you. Let it mean that God is willing to become one of us, and then willing to give Himself inside of us through the Holy Spirit to be among us, to walk with us, to be in relationship with us. That's His whole heartbeat, so we can do even greater things, because that's what He intended for us, the greater things. As Jesus was quick to tell His disciples, you will do even greater things than what I have done. And Jesus done a lot. Jesus done amazing works, but still, He was still wrapped up in a human flesh, just one person, and He was only able to do so much. That's why He's letting us be the part of it, and that's why He said, I have to go to give you something, someone even greater than myself. And that was the very Holy Spirit that breathed Him to life, and Mary was breathing new life into us so we can do this greater things. And this church, it's magnitude already. We've already seen the greater things through the disciples, but it doesn't stop there. It continues with us. We are to take this even further. We are to make these different. We are to be a difference maker. And I don't know what God's really speaking into you. Like I said, we covered yesterday talking about the Holy Spirit speaking into you. Just listen to that still small voice inside your mind and really connect to it and to find out what you're next. But you've got a passion. You've got a drive, and you're on the eve of something amazing. You're on the eve to start something fresh, something new, something amazing to do His work. So get excited for that. You are on the eve of something. And we never want to take a moment not to celebrate that you all have a next. Everybody has a next, and we're all created for this next to do amazing things. And we see that, and kind of flash forward on into Philippians, and that's what Paul wrote, like completely on down the road here a little bit. But in Philippians, Paul got it. He understood what it meant for God to be among us, and God to be in us, and God to be part of us. And it says, brothers, I do not consider that I have made it my own. But one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. Like I said, we got to center on what lies ahead of us. And we can't be focused in on what the people are going to say. Like Joseph, he ignored what the critics would say. He ignored what other people would think. And he took his place. He took his place on what God's calling was with him. And that's an amazing thing. And we have to look at that. We can't look what's behind us. We have to look what lies forward ahead of us. And that's what Joseph chose to do in this situation. He chose to look forward to the greater things. He was looking. And Paul even goes on and says, I press on towards the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. He knew the prize. He knew the goal. He knew where he was headed. He was on the eve of a breakthrough. Paul did amazing things through the church. I mean, just look back at most of the New Testament is Paul's letters to the church as he was doing great works, but he knew something was greater inside of him. And if we move on to Philippians just a little bit further, and this one verse that you hear so many times, most times painted on the gym wall, I can do all things through him who strengthens me. But it wasn't just about a lifting thing. It wasn't about this next rep in your workout, or this next few yardage, or what all you can do. It was really painting of a picture of not having anything, because he was writing this to a church. And so we see in Philippians chapter 4, verse 10, it says, I rejoiced in the Lord greatly that now at length you have revived your concern for me. You were indeed concerned for me, but you had no opportunity. Now that I'm speaking of being in need, for I have learned in whatever situation I am to be content. In whatever situation. I know how to be brought low, and I know how to abound in any and every circumstance. I have learned the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance and need. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. Because this was Paul painting a picture. It's because of Jesus I've got all things. Because of him, it doesn't matter if I'm abounding in wealth. It doesn't matter if I'm poor, if I'm broke, if I don't even know where my next meal is going to come from. Because God is with me. God is among me. God is walking for me. And that's how we need to be walking on this eve, knowing that God is with us, that we can make these next steps forward. We can work on this next that God has presented to us. And we can be hopeful to know that nothing's going to stand in our way when he is for us. And I'm here. He has got a next for every one of us. He's got a next for you. What is your next? I just want to paint that, just really get you to understand that they are a next. Don't feel disheartened. Don't feel like you're going at it alone. Like we shared last week, yesterday, but God is with us internally, and he's speaking truth into us. He's saying, I've created you for something greater. I have created you for more. You have to believe that. God wants greater things for you. He wants you to do the extraordinary, the amazing, the things that you can't take credit for because God is behind you. He wants you to be an overcomer in every situation. He wants you to look at any opportunity to represent Him in amazing ways. Don't let anything hold you back. Don't let what your worries about what other people think or what other people say or the negativity they speak into you. If you know it's a God calling, if you can hear His voice clearly speaking into you, then make that next step, whatever it may be. Walk into that. It can be your next ministry opportunity. It can be your next getting involved with the church. It can be your, I don't know what it is. It can be feeding the homeless. It can be whatever He's speaking into you. Don't let anything discourage you because you can do all things through Christ who came to empower you because it's God among us. And that's what we want to celebrate this Christmas. It's God among us. Jesus walked with us. He spoke with us. He loved on us. And then He took form and sent the Holy Spirit to be inside of us. So we're not going at it alone now. We are doing this. We have to always remember this greater thing and walk into it. We are called to do greater things. So this Christmas, just center on those greater things. Center on everything that God's brought you through, everything He's done for you. But you cannot remain there. You can't always just keep going to the past because so many times the past is going to hold us up. We keep looking to the past. That's where we're going to live. But it's always looking towards the future. Regardless of what we've been through, regardless of what we've done this year, or whatever you've been through, whatever struggles that you had to overcome, whatever struggles God brought you through, know that it's still in the past, that you still have greater things. No matter what situation you find yourself in money-wise, being in debt or whatever, whatever situation you find in your love life, in your marriage life, in your dating life, you can keep moving forward. This year is about a renewal, that we can step into that as we get ready to moving into this new year. But on the eve of something, prepare your heart for this Christmas to know that you're on the eve of something amazing, something great. Just like God was on the verge of just breaking down this wall, the barrier that we had between Him and us, and walk among us through Immanuel, God among us. He's going to do even greater things for you. And I just want you to know that. This Christmas, know that greater things are to come. And with all that being said, and maybe you're tuned in, and you've watched all this, and you really believe this greater thing, but you've never really, you don't have the personal relationship. Check out yesterday's message if you really want to know more about this personal relationship. But maybe your next is just walking into a relationship with God. Maybe you just need to start it right off the bat. This is an amazing day, Christmas Eve of 2018. You can walk into that as this being your day that you just dedicated your life to Christ and gave it all to Him and started that relationship. If that's you, I'd love to pray for you. And all it is receiving. It's not about giving. It's not about what you have to do to earn it or what all you have to say. It's just about just surrendering to it and say, I need you. I want a relationship with you, Father. Starting this relationship. He's God among us. That's what He wants. He wants a personal relationship. That's all it's about. It's about receiving the Holy Spirit inside of you and starting this walk with Him. He's going to change all things. He's going to make all things new. He's going to take you to that next. He's on the eve of something great with you. And it's just about receiving Him. Just like He was on the eve of being born as a man, just taking the infant form. He's on the eve of coming and starting a relationship inside of you and starting something new inside of you. So if that's you, I just want to pray for you and just call out to Him and just receive it. And I just want to pray for you as you just do that. Father, right now, whoever may hear this message, maybe this is that moment when they just need to receive you, just like you received the world, taking just coming into it, walking into it, just allow their hearts to be open and know it's just about receiving what we get from you. It's not about works. It's not about what we have to do or anything. It's all about just receiving you. Allow them just to hear your voice clearly. Allow them to open their heart just to receive you. Right now, in the name of Jesus, just make this new. Amen. And like I said, I'm here to encourage you. If you made that confession to God, if you cried out to Him, let us know. Share it. Send us a comment. Send us a message. Whatever it may be, because we want to celebrate with you. Whatever it may be, we want to come alongside of you and do life with you. And maybe you are a believer, and maybe you're really praying through what are you in the eve of? What is this next year going to bring? What is this going to really transition into? Use this day to celebrate that and really pray through that. Use Christmas to really celebrate and say, God, happy birthday to you, but let me give you something so much more. Let me get the what I've been giving you before. Let me surrender my life. Let me surrender my goals, my wills to you. Let me use this Christmas to really center in on that, and you guide me into my next point. And just use it. Use it and take it. We want to be with you through that too. So if you're ready for that next, contact us too. We'd love to celebrate you. Whatever means it may be. It's probably not going to always be through this ministry. It might be a ministry of your own or whatever it may be. We want to walk alongside of you and help point you into the right direction and connect you to the people who are going to help you. And we love just to be a part of that too. So just reach out to us. Contact us. We love y'all and thank y'all and hope you have a blessed Christmas. Excited for this Christmas season. Just celebrating Jesus. It's all about Jesus. And just tune in. And Thursday, we'll still be doing community group downtown Kingsport at the Neutral Grounds Coffee House. This virtual campus is the way to get the word out. And our meeting, our fellowship together is our community groups. And right now, we're meeting in Kingsport at the Neutral Grounds Coffee House. Come out. Get you a cup of coffee. Get you some amazing desserts. They've got some amazing things. And just come fellowship with us. Join with us in community. And we'll just love on you and meet you right where you're at and pray for you and encourage you and help center you. But that's what we're all about, is building community. But join us. Be a part of it. And if this video's blessed you in any way, share it. Get it out. Let's just blow up Facebook with this video, and hopefully it encourages somebody on this Christmas Eve. But thank y'all for just giving me this time to speak into your Christmas Eve or whatever point you may be watching this. It might not even be Christmas Eve when you're watching this. But just connect with us. But we love y'all and thank you for tuning in. All right. Have an amazing Christmas.